I'm Anthony L. Norwood, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association. And today, we bring you another exciting Black Buddhist lecture. My lecture today is called
Kushites, Ancient Black Buddhist and Buddhist History.
The Kushites developed civilizations all around the world. In fact, in Japan, they were called the Ainu. Now, what we call India today was known at the time of the Afro-Greek writer Homer. India was known as Eastern Ethiopia. And the Kushites, along the Sarasvati River, created the largest city and city planning that was 2,000 years before any people known as white people had ever had city planning. They created a complex or a city that was, or a civilization that was twice as large as Egypt and Mesopotamia put together. Now, what happened was this. It was not only the Buddha who was black. The black Buddhists would spread their religion around the world. White people called Greeks would adopt the Buddhist religion. These black Buddhists left India and moved to Africa, and they were called Israelis. We know these Jews, and they had a name, and they were called the Tribe of Judah. See, these black Buddhists were called many names. They conquered Egypt, and they were called the Hyksos, or the Shepherd Kings. You can see these black Buddhists in Egypt with the snake. The snake was called a Naga, and these Buddhists were called Nagas in India, but in Africa they were called Nubians. And we know about the Nubians, and the Nubians were Buddhists because the father of history, Herodotus, wrote about the Buddhists. They were not called Buddhists, they were called Jim Nesophis. Jim means naked, Sophis means philosophers, and Herodotus visited Nero, which is the capital, and it was Herodotus who said that Nero was the cradle of the Jim Nesophis. Also, I want you to look at a Buddhist temple in Africa, in Egypt. It's called the Apademak Temple. What you see in the Apademak Temple, you see carved, you see the Naga snake coming out of the lotus flower, and you see the Buddha head. See, Buddha was known as the sage of the chakras, or the lion of the chakras. Now, these black Buddhists were founders of what we know today as Rome. Now, look this up. The original Romans were called Etruscans. The Etruscans and the people of India they called Dravidians were one and the same people. They were also known by another name, and that is, they were known as the Samaritans. So when you look in the Bible and you read about the Good Samaritan, the Samaritans, the Etruscans, the Gemnosophists, Buddhists had many different names, but we know that they were Buddhists. In fact, there was another group of Buddhists. They were called the Krishnas, and the Krishnas spread their Buddhist religion all over Europe, and the white people took the Buddha and his mother. They were called Madonnas. Ask any white person or any religious person why you have black Madonnas. You have black Madonnas because that is the story of the Buddha and his mother. The baby Buddha's mother were the Madonnas. And this eventually became known as the religion of Christianity. Now, we can show you all of this Buddhist history, but when it comes to the Asians, when it comes to white people, they extricate all black Buddhist history, culture, and language. And we at the Proud Black Buddhists, as a part of our Buddhist practice, where the whites took it out, the Buddhists, we black Buddhists, put it back in. It was the Buddha, who a Buddhism that arrived in China 1,000 years after the death of Buddha. It arrived in Japan some 400 years later, about 1,400 years after the death of Buddha. Now, Asians and whites rewrote black history, or rewrote Buddhist history, by extricating all black Buddhist history. And the whites and the Asians practice this racism in our entire world. There does not exist one single black male who is honored and respected in the black community as a Buddhist. Imagine, black people have accomplished the greatest heights possible in our world. For example, Barack Obama, the first black president, became the most powerful man on planet Earth. Barack Obama was listed as the most admired man in America. You can go whether the Olympics or running corporations, the black guy runs NASA, the science, black people write books. There is not one known Buddhist who is known as a scholar who teaches the history of Buddhism. There is something wrong in the Buddhist religion that in all of the world you cannot find one single black male who is respected as a Buddhist. In the 2nd century AD, a white Kushan king from Afghanistan conquered the indigenous black people of India. King Kanishka created one of the world's first racist acts in that he separated Buddhism based on race, culture, and language. King Kanishka purposely changed the Buddha from black to white. We know this by his commissions that he did in the Gandhara images, where he made the Buddha look like a Greek. And the way that they got together and extricated black people from the Buddhist religion, they did it via a method called Sanskrit. See, the first evidence of Sanskrit is called the Rudra Danam, which happened in the AD. See, the language of Sanskrit came from the black language of Pali, and it was a language that was used to discriminate against black people. See, Sanskrit is the language of the Brahmins. The Brahmins used Sanskrit to rewrite all history. They extricated all black history, culture, and language from Buddhism. In fact, they created a writing called the Vedas. The Vedas are false writings, whereas they changed the history, they changed the culture, they changed the language, and they rewrote all the history. In fact, the Brahmins created a new religion. This new religion they created was called Hinduism. You see, the word Hindu does not exist in ancient Indian literature. The Hindus were the Brahmins, and what they did was they rewrote history via the Vedas, and how they got rid of the Buddha and made the Buddha, change the Buddha from black to white, is they incorporated the Buddha into what is called the Hindu pantheon. And they made the Buddha white, they rewrote all the history, they changed the dates, and they used racism. In fact, under King Kanishka, we find the first evidence of the caste system. The word caste comes from the word Varna. Varna means color, and this is the first evidence of racism that happened in our world 1900 years ago. You see, King Kanishka and a Brahmin by the name of Ashvaghosha created a new Buddhist religion called Mahayana Buddhism. Mahayana Buddhism is the time in history whereas all black culture, history, and language was extricated and Buddhism became separated by race. Now, archaeology, anthropology, literary science, genetic science, and linguistic science all prove not only were there no white people in ancient India, but it was blacks who first inhabited Asia. And whites and Asians, like black people, not only out of Buddhism, they extricate blacks out of the world history. In that you extricate all of the black culture, all of the black history out of the Buddhist religion. You see, even when it comes to the black Buddhist sage, Nidrin Shonin, you see, ladies and gentlemen, the original people of China and Japan were black. The original Japanese were called the Jomon people. Look up Jomon. They were the Jomon people. And the original black people of Japan were black people. And in the 13th century, there was a black Buddhist sage by the name of Nichiren Shonin. Nichiren Shonin looked at all the Mahayana Buddhism in Japan and declared that it was only the Lotus Sutra that was the correct teachings of the Buddha. Now, what the Japanese did, they converted Nichiren's Buddhism to Mahayana Buddhism, and it's based on race. You see, when the Buddhist religion got to Japan, and this is over 1,400 years after the death of the Buddha, the foundation of the platform of the Buddhist religion was based on a black Buddha. And you could see it at the Todaiji Temple. Now, the Todaiji Temple is in UNESCO. This is a World Heritage Site. And this World Heritage Site, it houses the largest indoor Buddha statue in the world, made of bronze and gold. This is called the Cosmic Buddha, when you see this in Japan. However, the Japanese who teach us Buddhism, they extricate all black Buddhist history from Buddhism. They don't even tell you that the messenger of the Buddha, Shakyamuni, was Nichiren Shonin, and he was black. They don't tell you. You see, Nichiren Shonin taught that the essence of the Buddhist teachings was only the Lotus Sutra. Now, what Nichiren did, Nichiren took the Pali word that's called Namu. Namu means to awaken. And he, you awaken to the Lotus Sutra. Now, he first intoned the words Myoho Renge Kyo. Now, the word Myo means correct. The word Ho means long. Now, the word Renge means lotus, which it represents the lotus flower or the law of cause and effect. And the word Kyo means teachings. It is the essence of the Buddhist teachings. See, Kyo is all, not only the Buddhist teachings, the word Kyo is all the teachings in the universe. Now, to white people who misled me by asking the question, what difference does it make whether the Buddha was black or white? You see, true history makes a lot of difference. And we at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are committed to teaching the true history of Buddhism. You see, Buddhist history is black history. Now, the answer to the question, what difference does it make whether the Buddha was black or white? The real question is racism and white superiority. See, in order to perpetrate white superiority, white people had to rewrite history and make the Buddha white. See, humans known as white people did not become dominant in the world stage until the AD. See, ancient world history is the story of black people who left Africa called Kushite. I am Anthony L. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, bringing you another Black Buddhist history lesson. Thank you very much.